like this is not a typo. 250 million people peacefully protesting, and the government using water cannons and digging up the highways so people can, you know, it's pretty chilly in Delhi right now. Uh-huh. And these people are just sitting on the roads, on highways, and they have left their homes, and it's a busy farming season. But, you know, it's like, I have nothing to lose.
Hey folks, today I was over at the Medicine Hat College for an interview with a person named TJ, who's organizing a group here in Medicine Hat that's taking part in a worldwide rally protest against a farming bill that passed in India. And you might ask yourself, how does this affect me? Well, I talked with TJ and he explained how it could affect Canadians and specifically people in our community and maybe what's inside your grocery shelves.
There was a law passed by the Indian government against the farmers without any consultation with the farmers. Basically, this law takes away the bargaining ability of the farmers to sell its produce, and basically gives the control to the corporate or big corporations. What we have seen in the past, the greed of big corporations, and just the struggle of the farmer as it is. But now it just puts them, you know, this is just another nail on the coffin. 150 million people are actively part of this protest. So this is on a global scale. This is a pretty big effects all across the world, because India is a net exporter of a lot of agriculture produce. So we don't see it now, but eventually it will end up, you know, seeing a domino effect all over the world.
What are the things that are in my cupboard right now that are produced in India?
Spices. You name any spices, they have roots in India. Rice is a big one. Subcontinent, and especially India, has the biggest proportion of the rice that gets exported out to the world. And if you want to eat rice tonight, I'm sure you can thank one of the farmers in India. There's a big propaganda through the nationalist media back home. The current ruling party is pushing through that we're Khalistanis, we're terrorists, there's a support from Pakistan. There is nothing like that, like nothing. Do I look like a terrorist? Oil and gas workers in Alberta, they have struggled in last 5-6 years. And you know, we see that effect, you know, people losing jobs, livelihood, and family separating, and suicides. It's just whole range of things, you know. There's things that I can't even think of. So this is no different. And you know, this is might be happening in the other part of the world, but through tweets, use social media, because you know, through this platform, if we can send the strong message just through mass media, journalism, that just sends a strong message that there are people out there, they care about this issue. So, you know, when it's like, that just puts more pressure on the government. Just, you know, like, it's like, okay, you know, this is an international issue now.